Let's use Lotta's approach of transforming variables on our Facebook dataset. Most of our variables, such as friend count, likes, comments, wall posts, and others, are variables that I would call engagement variables, and they all have very long tails. Some users have 10 times or even 100 times the median value. Another way to say this is that some people have order of magnitudes more likes, clicks, or comments than any other users. In statistics, we'd say that the data is overdispersed. Often, it helps to transform these values so we can see standard deviations or orders of magnitude so that we are, in effect, shortening the tail. Here was our histogram of friend count from before, and notice we still have that long tail. We can transform this variable by taking the log, either using the natural log, log base 2, or log base 10. We could also use other functions such as the square root, and doing so helps us to see patterns more clearly without being distracted by the tails. A lot of common statistical techniques, like linear regression, are based on the assumption that variables have normal distributions. So by taking the log of this variable, we can transform our data to turn it into maybe a normal distribution or something that more closely resembles a normal distribution if we'd be using linear regression or some other modeling technique. Now, I know we're not doing modeling here, but let's just see what it looks like to transform the variable. First, I'm going to just do this in the summary command. So here's our regular summary of friend count. Looks like the median friend count is 82 and the mean is 196. I can take the log base 10 of this friend count and get a different table. Now, this seems a little bit unusual since I have negative infinity for the minimum and negative infinity for the mean. So what must be going on? Well, some of our users have a friend count of 0. So when we take the log of base 10 of 0, that would be undefined. For those familiar with calculus, the limit would be negative infinity, which is why that appears here. To avoid this, we're going to add 1 to friend count, so that way we don't get an undefined answer, or negative infinity. There, that looks much better. And just to show you another function, let's also use the square root on friend count. This would be another type of transformation. For me, log base 10 is an easier transformation to wrap my head around, since I'm just comparing friend counts on orders of magnitude of 10. Basically a tenfold scale, like the pH scale. Now that you've seen transformations within summaries, let's see if you can apply a similar transformation to the histogram. Check out the instructor notes to learn about how to use scales and how to create multiple graphs on one page. Once you've read through those links and you think you're ready, try this next programming exercise. In it, you're going to create 3 different histograms. The first one will be our original friend count histogram, and then the second one will have the friend count transform using log 10. And the last histogram will have the friend count transform using square root. Now, I haven't given you all the information to do this exercise, but I want you to be resourceful. Part of being a good programmer is being able to read documentation and know how to find your answers to the questions you may have. Now, we've already done the legwork for you by providing the resource, so let's see if you can figure it out.